According to the Auditor General's report of the financial year 2020-2021, the MRI machine, which was delivered and installed at Mulago Hospital in 2018, has since then never been used. But the hospital went on to spend 474.47 million on its refurbishment. Park committee members queried hospital management over the matter.
It is there idle, but we must spend 474 million just to put the helium, which is understandable that because if we don't do that, it will completely go to waste. But couldn't we find space where to place this MRI machine so that it can, the services can be provided?
Personally, I have received many people who come here requesting for support to be facilitated to get MRI services. And I keep insisting we have ours. We have ours. So put yourself in the shoes of the Ugandans who really need this service. And it is taking long.
The committee raised concern over huge chunks Ugandans incur to receive MRI services in private facilities while the public MRI machine is down.
We get this machine functional because you know what it means for Ugandans to go to the private health facilities for MRI services. You know the cost implications, the inconveniences that come with it. And it's really very unfortunate that we continue to spend over 400 million on an equipment that is non-functional.
In their defense, they explained that the 474 million was spent on filling helium gas that had leaked out of the machine due to prolonged periods of non-use.
Now, what they are querying is the expenditure on helium.
Mm-hmm.
And this helium, with the time, we have to keep refilling. It's not only during that time, but every other time, the helium has to be refilled.
Park still grilled Mulago Hospital management over the poor state of medical equipment, some non-functional, while others are in poor working conditions. These include autoclaves in the central stellar department, patient monitors in emergency department, blood coagulation machine in clinical laboratory unit, ICU beds in the intensive care unit, and CT machine in the radiology department.
Because, Chair, definitely, I am very sure that there will be challenges on maintenance. And after 6 months or 1 year, they will tell you most of this expensive equipment is non-functional, and patients have to be referred to the private sector.
Let's look forward to contracting these people to run those services. When the equipment get a challenge, they're able to carry them and go. Otherwise, as a country, just one nut is making a whole very important system in Nebbi Hospital to go down.
Meanwhile, the second time, the former Mulago National Referral Hospital Executive Director, Dr. Biarugaba Baterana, has failed to account for the 2 billion that was allegedly overpaid to Umeme.
The most pending and immediate question and observation is that they actually paid more arrears than they had. Yeah. And actually, I'm sure the authors are following. By putting this figure here in the wrong place, Honorable Chair, it was deliberate.
The amount of electricity which was consumed during the financial year, we put it in this document, and all the EFTs that actually we paid, and what would be remaining, when you pay also the arrears, what would remain as this figure which we have as a cumulative outstanding commitment as of June that year.
After hitting a stalemate, the committee vice chairperson Asuman Basalira, who chaired the session, deferred the query and assigned a committee member, Xavier Choma, to who is a top accountant, to dig deep into the matter and report back to the committee.
We should hand over his document to you. You look at it vis-a-vis what we have. Then along the way, we will come back to this issue because we are working, we're a little bit disadvantaged that we don't have it.
In the same vein, Park interrogated Baterana over unexplained adjustment to the opening balance of payables amounting to 2.9 billion shillings. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.